So today we are going to be looking at Sam Walton, Made in America. It's by Sam Walton. It's an autobiography piece, although I'm pretty sure it's ghostwritten. So the book is about Sam Walton, who is the founder of Walmart, which is a very large commercial discount retailer in the United States. The book's about his life, specifically focusing on the rise and the creation of Walmart. Now, this review is going to be a little bit shorter, but to summarize a little bit, discount stores weren't really a thing when Sam Walton started. I forget the years. I think I want to say, like, in the 50s. He started in retail. He started in other people's stores, working as an employee, and then worked his way up. Had a lot of experiences over a very long period of time, and came to the conclusion that the way to really do business was volume, and to, you know, just make just a tiny bit of money off the top, and then just sell a bunch of stuff. And this was very novel at the time he started doing this, whereas most retailers would mark up 25%. He would mark up just like, so if the item cost him 90 cents, he would charge like 95 cents or something. And most other retailers would charge like $1.15 or, you know, $1.35, whatever it is, something like that. And so it was pretty revolutionary at the time. I read this in large part for balance reasons. So this book is a little bit outside the wheelhouse of kind of what I normally read. I don't read too many business-oriented books or biography-oriented books, but generally speaking, I kind of have a anti-corporation sentiment, and so I try and, whenever I identify a sort of way I feel about things, I try and read stuff that's inconsistent with this. So this is very pro-corporation sort of messaging, and I think that it's important to see other perspectives. In particular, I was quite moved by a lot of things that Walton said. So first, one of the things that I found particularly moving was he just doesn't seem that interested in money in terms of like having it and spending it. Obviously, money is like the name of the game, but it's more a craft sort of thing for Walton, it seems, or it was. He's passed now. And this I found tremendously interesting. Like, he had a very humble life, and one of the things he constantly like harps on in the book is trying to get the cheapest thing for the customer. So trying to get the customer the absolute lowest prices. So for example, when he talks about talking to distributors, he's like, if I have to pay this distributor an extra 10%, then, you know, I gotta charge the customer an extra 10%. And so try and haggle really hard with the distributors, like get the very rock bottom price. And he is disinterested with, I think to use some of the language he uses, eating someone else's inefficiency. And so it's all about streamlining. Let's see, there are like, one of the things is he addresses how people kind of accuse Walmart of pushing out all the mom and pop or community stores. He's like, look, those stores are inefficient and they're going out anyways. It's kind of his attitude towards that. In the past, I've seen accusations been made that Walmart opens up stores with the intention of eventually closing them just to drive small retailers out of business in local areas and then force people to commute to nearby Walmarts, but not the location that actually drove out the business. This is interesting. He doesn't address this directly, but okay. My impression on reading this, and obviously it's going to be trying to make Sam Walton look good because it's his book, but despite that, I still had the impression that he seems like a good guy, and that I am quite happy I read this, you know, as a sort of balance to anti-corporate sentiment. Because when people go ragging on business, they forget that businesses are also providing something that's like very useful. Like, the businesses get huge for a reason. Like, the reason that Amazon is huge is because they provide a useful service, right? And they also engage in anti-competitive, or like, they engage in processes that are dubiously ethical, but then they also provide, like, a good service, and it's important to recognize that there's multiple factors at play, and if you can't do something efficiently, as efficiently as the next guy is going to take the business. Unless the consumer wants to buy from a different place for some other reason. So if you don't like that Amazon mistreats its warehouse workers, you can just buy from some other company for more. Anyways, let's get into the ratings a little bit. For utility, I gave it a 3.5. This is pretty low. I don't think it's... Perhaps I rated this too lowly. I think that the usefulness comes from just kind of hearing Walton's, like, thought processes on business, and that maybe if you can apply that to business for yourself, that'd be useful. Kind of just his perspective on, like, seeking efficiency, doing things yourself, you know, his overall attitude towards managing people. Maybe it deserved a little higher than 3.5, but at the same time, it's, if you're looking for that sort of thing, this isn't, like, the best book for getting that, because it's, like, it's a biography piece, right? So, something that is just outlining, like, business principles only without talking about life history is probably going to be much more effective, and so that is one of the reasons I gave it a low score on utility, but perhaps it should be higher. You know, he talks about, the stuff I was interested in is him talking about anti-competitive practices and talking about, one thing is he, like, profit shares with employees, like, if they put money into a particular type of, like, retirement account, he, like, the Walmart, like, matches it with, like, Walmart stock or something like that. But, okay. For novelty, I give it a 3.5. I don't think any of the information in here is just, like, crazy out there. Like, you'd never hear it from someone else if you didn't hear it from Sam Walton. And also, I think if you just didn't read this book, it would be fine. That said, if you are like me and kind of just have a large distrust for major corporations in a general sense, and I still do, even after reading this, then my like intuition is that reading some book, not necessarily this one, that is by someone or about someone like operating a large corporation is probably a good look just for balance reasons. But other than that, novelty, low score. If you don't read this book, that's fine. Okay, entertainment, I gave it 5.5. It's not like it's a book to, like, read for sort of more entertainment because it's, like, a biopiece, but then it doesn't have, like, a narrative structure of an actual book because it's a biopiece. And so it's pretty entertaining, or it's, like, it's above average on the entertainment factor. It's not, like, a technical book. He's talking about, you know, his life and stuff, and some of that is fairly interesting, and so I gave it entertainment at 5.5. For style, it is a rather sort of plain style that is, like, somewhat reminds me of, I mean, I don't want to say Hemingway, but, like, Hemingway, just very basic, straightforward, without it being, like, sounding like it was written by a fourth grader. So it just has this, like, kind of, you know, I don't want to say rural feel, but, like, rural feel, just, you know, basic, to the point, clear. It's well written. I like the writing style. I'm a huge fan of Hemingway. But it's just kind of got that type of feel. My understanding is it's ghostwritten. Which means someone else wrote it, Walton oversaw, like, the information, and it reads well. Like, just because something is basic and simple doesn't mean it's poorly written, it just means it's simply written. For readability, I gave it an 8. Really easy read. Just about anyone, I think, could read this. The reason I didn't give it a higher score is because it's not communicating information that is hard to communicate, I don't think. So, like, readability is, like, a cross-section of communicating difficult information and then accessibility. It's like a 10 on accessibility, or 9.5 or something, but it's not communicating difficult information, so I gave it an 8. For interest, I gave it a 6.5. It is interesting to hear about his viewpoints on how business should be conducted. obviously he is very successful in business, although I think in large part that is being in the right place at the right time and getting there first. And so it's not that I think his... if you, like, transported a Sam Walton in time and you put him here today, I don't think he would start a chain that would, like, destroy current Walmart or, like, Target or whatever, current, like, retailers. He was kind of the first to the discount retailer sort of thing, where their goal was not to make a large amount of money on each item, but to do really large volume. Another thing that was very original to Walton was having, like, promotional things. So he used to have, like, ice cream out front, like, this is really early on, like, ice cream out front of the shop, where you, like, make no profit on, but it's just to get people in the store, or have a sale on an item that the price is just so insanely low that people drive, like, multiple counties just to get it, but then you get them in the store. And so this was... in Walton's time, very revolutionary, but I'm uncertain he would be as successful today, you know, if he had the same knowledge. Although there are different sort of innovations that are important today for doing well. And Amazon does the really large volume, really low margin thing very well for, like, a very long time. Amazon showed, like, no profit, basically. And they would make, like, fractions of a cent per transaction in the aggregate or something like that. And then, you know, it was just volume. Although now they do better than that. So overall, as far as recommendations go, I would not widely recommend this book. I don't think it was, like, awful or wrong. I'm very happy I read it. Because I think it was important for balancing out some of my perspectives on things and providing alternative viewpoints. But for the most part, I wouldn't recommend this book extremely strongly unless you have a bit interest in specifically brick-and-mortar retail or Sam Walton himself or, like, Walmart. Like, those sorts of things, unless you're in that niche, would not recommend it. If you are... the book is well written, well enough written. It's a biography piece. Generally, I don't like biographies. But if that sort of thing is in the realm of what interests you, then this book is a fairly good read. As far as discussion goes, is there what millionaire or billionaire or business exec do you think has the most interesting life story? Alright, and if you like this, feel free to give it a like. If you want to see more, subscribe, and have a good one.